Hello guys, Jim here, and welcome to another episode of Kerbal Space Program. In this episode, we're going to be sending a moon miner to the moon, of course. So here we are with the first launch. This is MOS Miner Mach 1, which of course is the miner. So the whole goal of this is to keep the space station supplied with fuel by mining the surface of the moon. Alright, let's open up this. Here we go. Take a nice look at this beautiful miner that I built. And I've tested to see how long this thing takes to mine the ore and fill all the tanks on the craft and to convert it into fuel. And it takes about a year in game time. So it's not exactly the most efficient way to get fuel. But hey, I don't have to keep launching fuel tanks or anything to the space station or the moon station every time it needs fuel. So we're just adjusting our approach. So we're just gonna circleize our orbit, and then we're going, after we circleize it, we are going to make sure we're on the same inclination as the moon station, so when we do take off, we can rendezvous with it pretty easily. Also, as you can see, I have put a satellite in orbit around the moon. I didn't put it in the video, me putting it around the moon, but it's basically just a probe to see where the ore is. So now I got location set, and now we're going to land accordingly. I believe it takes about half the fuel on the miner to land this thing. So, land with half fuel, and then fill it back up, and then I also have about, like, see down at the bottom, you can see those orange, small orange circular tanks, about, I think, like, five of them or so. Those are empty, because those are the ones I want to fill. I want those to be reserved only for extra fuel to store on the moon orbiting station. So here we are, we got our panels extended, extend our radiators, and we're gonna plant the flag. Here is the landing site of Miner Mach 1 on its mission to keep the MOS fuel sources stocked. I didn't see what this cripple's name is, but he is going to stay here for quite some time, mining the moon of its sources and converting it into fuel. There it is, the moon orbit station, flying overhead. Starting the fuel converters, and here's our next mission of the video. This is the little Kerbin Orbit Shuttle Mach 1, and it's going to be delivering two fuel tanks, two of the 3.5 meters, no, it's 2.5 meter fuel tanks into little Kerbin Orbit. Watch out, we do have a flip here. I still have yet to perfect the shuttle design, but luckily I still have engines on the shuttle, just in case something like that does happen before I can achieve an orbital trajectory. So now here we are, setting up our orbit and burning. Now we can use our monopropellant engines and transfer some fuel from those fuel tanks into the main engine. Alright, so I'm just gonna fix our orbit a little bit using our monopropellant engines. Okay, now it's time to release our cargo, which is the fuel tanks. And these fuel tanks will be destined to journey off to the moon station, so I can have some tanks to store the fuel that the miner mines off of the moon. So now I'm just going to fix the orientation of the fuel tanks, and then we're going to head off and land this space shuttle back at Kerbal Space Center. I will admit, it took me about 4 tries or so to successfully land this craft, but I have edited those out, so you won't have to watch those. So we are setting up our return. At first, it may seem like I lose control of the craft. It kind of spins a little bit. But I do regain control, and I glided in with the assistance of my monopropellant engines, as you'll see shortly. See, I kind of lose a bit of control there, but I do manage to pull out of the dive. So there we go. So activate my propellant engines to make sure I don't fall too fast. So 4 times speed here. Actually, 8 times I'm accelerating in game. So now back to 4 times speed, and now we're lining up to the runway. Turn off our engines. And here we go, preparing for landing back at Kerbal Space Center. After a successful mission. Most successful, if you know, don't count the deferting after failing to land. But don't worry about that. That never happened in this world. Here we are, pulling up to the space plane hangar. There we go. Mission over. And now, for our third and final launch, is the MOS MTF-T, also known as the Moon Orbiting Station Main Tank of Fuel Tug. Yeah, it's a mouthful. So anyways, we're going to go up to the fuel tanks that I just placed in orbit with the shuttle. Rendezvous with it, dock with it, and then bring it over to the Moon Orbiting Station, where it will stay for the remainder of its lifetime. Now it's time to set up our orbital insertion burn and also our rendezvous. So there we go. Deploy the fairings, and there you can take a look at our craft. As you can see there, I put a big radar dish on there because I forgot there was a communitron on there. So I thought I did have one on there, and it Oh, it's kind of closed it. Because when I do open it, it goes inside of my model propellant tank. So I'm like, it looks too weird. Anyways, we are fine-tuning our rendezvous. Trying to use as much fuel in that main tank as we can. Right. Now we are going to head for the rendezvous. Once again, I also have a goofed up moment where I tried docking to the wrong docking port. So bear with me when I do that. As you can see, I have the 2.5 meter docking port. But I tried to dock with the 1.5 meter docking port. It's kind of funny. So I'm just orientating this the right way. As you can see, it's kind of hard to tell that there's the wrong docking port. But I noticed it was like right before I was about to touch it. And I was like, oh crap, this is the wrong docking port. So just bear with me as I have this epic fail here as I'm thinking about the dock, but then I'm like, oh shit, that's the wrong docking port, that's not good. Let's bump into it. That's not good. So now I was gonna turn this thing around. Just trying to orient it the right way. And now we can finally dock after that blooper. Kind of rough docking, but still worked. Now I'm just gonna, I'm trying to figure out how much fuel it will take to get to the moon, and we'll have to use fuel from the fuel tanks. And it does turn out I will have to, so I do end up enabling crossfeed and open up one of the tanks for consumption, which I just did there. It's hard to see since it was fast forwarded, but I enabled crossfeed and enabled the drainage of one of the tanks. But I have it set to drain after the main fuel tank drains. Here I'm like, okay, I have enough. I don't need to use the fuel in those tanks. So I'll uncheck those. But later on in the mission, I will have to use that fuel. We are about to start an insertion burn to enter orbit around the moon, or the mun, however you want to pronounce it. Here we are fixing our inclination, so it's relative to the space station, and set up a rendezvous. But I made a mistake, as you can see, like always. I always seem to make a mistake somehow, and I realized that this correction burn actually made it so I was going to crash into the moon. So I went for another attempt. So now it's time to figure out how to get to the rendezvous with this. There we go. We kind of want to apologize, guys, for a long wait for this video, because I started recording this video over a month ago. I recorded me putting this fuel tank into low Kerbin orbit, like the middle of January, and now it's like the end of February, so I apologize. I just last weekend I finally recorded the other bits of footage, because I was like, well, I better give you guys this episode, and I really want to start making videos again, so I'm sorry about that. But anyways, here we are approaching the space station, try to get as close as we can. So now I'm trying to figure out, where am I going to dock this thing to? So I decided to actually undock from this. Move this out of the way, because I'm not going to be docking that to the station. I'm just going to be docking the fuel tank to the station. But before I can dock the fuel tank to the station, I have to get my tug over there. Yes, my little moon orbiting station tug. This is why you always need a little tiny RCS tug. It's for when you have big loads that don't have their own monopropellant supply and need to be docked to the station. These are very useful at doing this. Line up for the docking. Boop, boop. There we go. So now I'm gonna dock it to the other set of fuel on the station. This thing, even with the extra RCS tug, did take quite a while to move. It accelerated very slowly. So it's much harder to do fine adjustments. But I did eventually get it docked. It's kind of funny from this angle. It kind of looks like the moon orbiting station is like on the ground when it's not fast forwarded. It kind of looks like it's kind of like sitting there, or just like hovering like right above the surface. I think it looks pretty cool like that. And also, guys, let me know what you want to see in the next episode. If you guys want to see me build a moon base, you know, to utilize this moon station. Or if you guys want me to see me build a station around Minmus, or do a mission to Minmus. Or go somewhere like Duna. So let me guys know what you want to see in the next episode. So here we are, coming up with the final approach. Trying to get the right adjustments here, but this thing is so heavy, it's so hard to do some fine adjustments, so I just pretty much have to just go for it and hope it docks, which it did successfully. It just started to wobble because I forgot to turn off the RCS. It's kind of a funny thing about space stations, if you don't forget to turn off the RCS, it does that. Now I'm just going to deorbit this thing, since there's no use for it, since it has no fuel. And thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.